If you want to install Bluetooth on Home Assistant, there are quite a few different ways. First of all, it depends on which Home Assistant installation type you have and also the hardware on which you have Home Assistant installed on. Let's start with the simplest. If you have a Raspberry Pi with Home Assistant OS installed on it, made for Raspberry Pis, well, your Raspberry Pi probably has a Bluetooth chip inside. So it might be worth a shot if you didn't already have it installed to go into the integrations tab and start looking for the Bluetooth integration. Me, I don't have Home Assistant OS, I have Home Assistant running on a Docker container, and I don't have Bluetooth exposed to it. So it's telling me no Bluetooth adapter found. But on the simplest installation of Home Assistant, which is the Raspberry Pi, you might already have it. You might also want to try this same method if you installed Home Assistant OS on a mini PC or any dedicated computer on which you installed Home Assistant OS, so directly on the computer and it's not on Docker or virtualized environment. If it doesn't work, however, it means that probably the chip that is inside your mini PC or your dedicated computer on which you installed Home Assistant OS on isn't recognized by Home Assistant or is simply not set up properly. And if that's the case, you should go to the Home Assistant Bluetooth page, which is gonna be listing a lot of resources that will help you. But by going through this page, you can already see that it's starting to be a mess and that maybe there is another solution that could be way easier and way better. So if you're like me, you probably thought, okay, whatever I have Bluetooth or not on my computer, in my case, a Synology NAS or a mini PC, why not buy a USB Bluetooth dongle or just take the one that you have laying around, plug it in the machine and expose it in some way. Well, that could work. It is worth a try. On the Home Assistant Bluetooth page, you have a list of all the working Bluetooth adapter and the one you may have may also be listed. So it might be just worth the shot if you're running Home Assistant OS bare bone or if you're running Home Assistant OS on the Docker container to just plug it and go look for the Bluetooth integration. If you're running it on a Docker container, however, you will have to expose it manually, so with the Docker Compose. And you can do this by adding this line here on your Docker Compose. So that might, all of those solutions might be worth a shot before buying a dedicated Bluetooth dongle. So if you buy one dedicated Bluetooth dongle, make sure that it is one of those. Even though I am pretty skeptical of this installation method because dongles, like Zigbee dongles, Bluetooth dongle, Wi-Fi dongles, anything that is connected to USB is prone to having a lot of interferences and wireless perturbations. So my first advice here is, if you have a USB Bluetooth dongle that is already compatible with Home Assistant, use it. Don't buy anything else. If you don't, however, there is a much simpler solution and more reliable solution, which are proxies. And there are two ways in which you can do proxies, and one of them I didn't expect it at all. And it's quite a funny thing that I really love. So if you have a Shelly device, which is generation 2 or above, it can act as a Bluetooth proxy, meaning that you can have your Bluetooth devices connecting to the Shelly Gen 2 device that you have. And you can use your Shelly to have a Bluetooth on your Home Assistant, which is amazing. Honestly, props to Shelly for doing that, because it's really the smart home spirit, you know? So they went and they developed a product and they said, okay, so since it has Bluetooth, let's expose it to Home Assistant users so they can even add other Bluetooth modules that are not forcibly Shelly's onto Home Assistant thanks to our Bluetooth module. That is fantastic, to be honest. Okay, so what if you don't have a Shelly Gen 2 device and you want to have a Bluetooth on your Home Assistant via the best way possible? And the best way possible is using a Bluetooth proxy on those devices. This device is an ESP32, maybe you already have heard of it, and if you don't, you probably should get 10 units of this. If you absolutely don't know what those are, maybe you already know Arduino, and if you don't, it's okay. Basically, this thing is a microcontroller. It has a chip that will run forever and forever with the instruction you gave him. What's interesting about this over the Arduino is the fact that it embeds a Wi-Fi chip and sometimes even a Bluetooth chip, a Zigbee and Thread chip. So those things are awesome to create your own smart home devices. I did this already with a little accessory lamp that I bought at the supermarket that wasn't smart at all. And I couldn't use a smart plug to smartify it, let's say, because every time that you had to turn it on, you had to press the button on the side to turn it on, and it would turn on only in a certain sequence. So what I did is that I basically cracked it open. I made a TikTok video about it. I soldered one of those and I installed a little software that allows me to control it remotely via Home Assistant. It's about 10 lines of code and it's also just a few clicks. So really, if you don't have those ESP32s, I encourage you to go and buy them. They are inexpensive. Be careful about the AliExpress counterparts. I will link in the description the ESP32 that I use at home. So these things have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth on it, which are perfect to create a Bluetooth proxy. So how will that work? You will flash this little device with the software that will make use of the Bluetooth chip that is inside, and you will expose it to Home Assistant. Therefore, when you have any Bluetooth device to connect to Home Assistant, it will pass through the ESP32. And Home Assistant will send order to your Bluetooth device via the ESP32. So Home Assistant via Wi-Fi commands the ESP32, and the ESP32 sends the command via Bluetooth to your Bluetooth device. Now I know that this looks like, when you see this thing, it can look complex or complicated to use, but it's really not. And I tell you why, because the people that are behind Home Assistant created a dedicated software called ESPHome that facilitates the use of those devices inside Home Assistant. So really, they made it super easy for you to create your own smart objects and smart solution that are tailored to your smart home. So let's go and add Bluetooth via those chips, ESP32. I'm gonna show you directly how to do it. It's very easy. So first things first, you wanna go to this URL, esphome.io/projects and Bluetooth. And here you have basically an only one page where you can just go ahead and plug your ESP32, which is something that I'm gonna do right now. So now basically you just go ahead, you click on Bluetooth proxy, make sure that generic ESP32 is selected. And before clicking connect, you might wanna install the appropriate drivers for your computer in order for your computer to recognize the ESP32 that you just connected. So you will go on the link that I provide in the description, and you're gonna install the CP210 drivers. The drivers are available for Windows and macOS and works best with Google Chrome. So once you install it, you go back to this page, maybe you relaunch Google Chrome and you click on connect. Here you will have a list of devices and you will click on the one that you just connected to your computer. If you ever run into some problems connecting the ESP32, what you can do is simply press the boot button here. So this button right here where it's written boot, you press it and hold it when you connect the USB cable, and this might help the device to connect to the computer. And if you don't know which device to click on, because there are sometimes too many, just click on cancel, you unplug the device and you click on connect and you see if some devices disappeared. In my case it did, so I'm gonna click on cancel again, replug the device. And if I click on connect, they should have reappeared. Now, if you still do have two devices that are here that are likely the same, it's just two different protocols, but it's the same device. So you can try both. I might try with the USB serial. Let's type connecting and install the ESPHome.Bluetooth proxy. So let's just click on this. Install, everything will be erased. Okay, install. And now it's installing. So just wait a little moment. Once it's done, you should have this pop-up here with prompts to connect to your Wi-Fi. So you're gonna send your Wi-Fi credentials to the ESP32 device. So don't worry about putting your access point password. Everything is done locally. What you see here is the ESP32 running and detecting Wi-Fi networks locally. I just paste my password and connect. All right. The device is now connected to the network. You can click here on Add to Home Assistant, but we're gonna do it manually just to show you how easy that is. On your Home Assistant instance, go into the integrations. And as you can see here, you have a new Bluetooth proxy. Here it's telling me reconfigure because I already had this device added before, so it recognized it. So let's just type on reconfigure. So for you, it's gonna be an add button. You're gonna be prompted to add it into a zone, and that will be it. If it wasn't automatically discovered, however, you might wanna go and add integration and look for ESPHome, which is the software that is currently running on your ESP32. And now you wanna put the IP address of your ESP32. In order to find the IP address of your ESPHome device, you might just wanna go back to this page and look for logs and console. And you can scroll down until you see the Wi-Fi connected line and you're gonna be able to find the IP address of your ESP32. In this case, you just need to copy and paste it here. If you don't find any relevant logs inside the console, you might just go ahead and look on your router device to look for the IP address. So if I go on my devices list for my IoT network, you can see the ESP32 that we just connected here, and clicking on it here, it will give you the IP address. Once you added it to Home Assistant, you may start to see automatically discovered Bluetooth device. For example, I have the SwitchBot curtains 3, two of them actually, and it already detected them. If that's not the case, you want to go into the integration, add integration, and find the brand of the device that needs to be connected via Bluetooth. In my case, it's SwitchBot. Let's go to SwitchBot, and you can see that it has discovered them automatically, but you can just go and manually fetch them with the SwitchBot Bluetooth. So let's just see how well it works. I have my two curtain monitor here, and just tap on add, yes, setup. Area, living room, and it's one of them. So you can see here, it's already available. So let's tap on it and try to close it. Yeah, as you can see, it's working pretty nice. And that's it, it's pretty responsive. This is probably the best way you can add Bluetooth to Home Assistant. So what can you do from here? Well, first, add your Bluetooth devices. But since you already made your way into the ESP Home ecosystem, dare I say, you might actually want to do a little more with it. ESPHome is not only just an integration, it also is a Home Assistant add-on or a Docker container you can run. And if you actually install the ESPHome add-on or the Docker container, you will see that it discovered your Bluetooth proxy device. And from this point, you can adopt it into your system to modify the configuration manually if you want to, or else you can just leave it automatically as it is. But what I can tell you is that since your device, the ESP32, is a wonderful device which has Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, Zigbee, and sometimes Threads, you can do just more. For example, I could have used the accessory lamp that I have right next to my TV and also use it as a Bluetooth proxy, because why not? After all, the Bluetooth chip is laying here, it's not doing anything, it's just receiving Wi-Fi commands and turning on and off the light. But I could have also used the Bluetooth chip in it. So let's adopt our device, give it a name. Once again, this is absolutely non-mandatory, but you can do that. Now it even proposes you updates that are available, so you can do them or not. But you can go ahead and edit directly your configuration. And if you need inspiration of what you can do, you can go on the ESP Home website, and there are plenty of projects that you can take inspiration from. If you hear DIY examples, there are a lot of things that you can do. Building a cheap air quality sensor, the first one that I found, It's amazing. You can do a lot of things. This is basically an Arduino board, which is once again a microcontroller. You can connect sensors to it. You can connect really anything basically and make use of it with ESPHome, and ESPHome does the hard work of communicating with Home Assistant for you. One thing that I'm particularly interested in these days is the voice assistant thingy. So having a voice assistant powered by AI that can handle and manage your smart home for you. And an ESP32 wired to a microphone can just do that. It can be a satellite in your house to pick up on your voice and run commands on your behalf. So here, for example, it's another simple project that you can use, and it tells you what to do, how to use it. It's really amazing. So that's it. I really hope this video was helpful. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I will gladly answer them. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye. By the way, if you still don't know which installation method and on which hardware to install Home Assistant on, I made a video explaining just that, so you might want to check it out as well.